Elon Musk reveals plan to colonize Mars. Billionaire Elon Musk has for years made many claims about the colonization of Mars that most specialists and scientists consider exaggerated. Yet his company SpaceX has also shown how capable it can be when it comes to space travel. Now the entrepreneur has given another speech about his fantasy of colonizing the Red Planet, providing a roadmap detailing the company's plan to achieve the ambitious arrival on Mars. According to some experts, Elon Musk's new plan seems tangible, or to some extent, possible, since it's based on existing technology and meager costs. But what is that plan, and what does it consist of? Do we already have an estimated date when the first humans will arrive on Mars? Keep watching. In a presentation to SpaceX employees at the company's Starbase facility in Texas, Musk outlined what the path to making life multi-planetary will be. On this occasion, he emphasized the company's two most important vehicles, the Falcon 9, currently the most widely used primary launch vehicle for Earth orbit, and the Starship spacecraft, which is intended to take humans to the planet Mars. Falcon 9. This spacecraft developed by SpaceX has revolutionized access to space by offering more accessible and frequent commercial launches than its competitors. This has enabled companies and government agencies worldwide to send satellites, conduct supply missions to the International Space Station, the ISS, and carry out various scientific and exploration missions. Even in 2020, it transported astronauts to the International Space Station for the first time along with its new Crew Dragon spacecraft. That same year, it began regular service to the ISS to fly astronauts back and forth. The most distinctive feature of the Falcon 9 is its ability to be reused. SpaceX has repeatedly demonstrated the reusability of the Falcon 9's first stage, significantly reducing launch costs by allowing a single spacecraft to be used on multiple missions. This innovation has fundamentally changed the economics of spaceflight by offering cheaper and more frequent launches. Without a doubt, SpaceX has demonstrated that it has the talent and technology to carry out the goals it sets for itself. However, many specialists have repeatedly indicated that the goal of colonizing Mars is still far from the company's capabilities, since this would require delivering millions of tons of cargo to Mars in very short periods, which is both tricky and expensive. But while thousands of payload space launches seem impossible, SpaceX has completed 327 successful Falcon 9 launches, and 80% of them have involved repurposed boosters. It's also estimated that this year, SpaceX will launch about 90% of the mass sent into orbit from Earth. China will launch about 6%, and the rest of the world will account for only 4%. You heard that right. SpaceX will be in charge of sending 90% of all the payloads into space, such as artificial satellites, spacecraft, and space modules that will be launched this year. Still, is it doubtful they can carry out thousands of launches to supply a colony on Mars? Starship, the bridge to Mars. This reusable launch system and spacecraft assembly were designed to transport cargo and passengers to Earth orbit, the Moon, Mars, and beyond. The expected payload of this powerful spacecraft is up to 150,000 kilograms. However, it has not reached that figure yet. If it does, it would become the most powerful rocket in history and the first 100% reusable orbital rocket. As the most powerful rocket ever created, Starship will be able to carry into orbit the massive payloads needed for large-scale missions to Mars. But there's still a lot to do before any of that can happen. Starship has suffered significant setbacks, such as an explosion during several of its test flights. In its third and most recent launch, it reached space for the second time, being the most successful launch, but the rocket did not survive its re-entry and crashed into the ocean. Landing and repurposing Starship's upper stage will take longer since it must first survive the fiery re-entry through Earth's atmosphere. On its last test flight in March, this vehicle broke up and burned up while attempting to return through the atmosphere. The next test of the Starship will involve landing the Starship booster on a platform in the ocean. Then, in the fifth test, SpaceX will attempt to get the booster to land on an actual launch tower at Starbase in Texas, thus cementing its capabilities as a 100% reusable super heavy rocket. While there's no word on when we'll be able to see the powerful Starship spacecraft land like its Falcon 9 siblings do, the company hopes to do so by next year. Hey, before moving on, be sure to like or dislike the video so that we can improve them for you, the viewer. Plus, don't forget to subscribe to our channel by making sure to hit the notification bell so you don't miss any of our daily videos. Reuse is the key. A single spacecraft won't be able to do all the work, so the company plans to build 6 additional Starship vehicles this year and ramp up production by 2025 as a new factory comes online at Starbase's facility. The Starship will also increase in size, mainly by expanding its length. Musk outlined the company's plans for a Starship 2, capable of launching 100 tons into low Earth orbit in fully reusable mode, and a Starship 3 with a capacity of 200 tons or more. If this seems unrealistic, consider that SpaceX made 4 significant upgrades to the Falcon 9 rocket from 2010 to 2018, more than doubling its performance and payload capacity. These larger Starship vehicles will be needed to reduce the number of refueling missions needed to load a vehicle into Earth orbit for a trip to the Moon or Mars. The goal is to reach a configuration in which it will only take 5 or 6 refueling missions to fill a spacecraft capable of landing 200 tons of payload on Mars. The final Starship 3 vehicle will be about 150 meters or 500 feet tall, about 20% larger than the current vehicle. This will allow additional fuel to be used to increase the lifting capacity. Musk said the company should be able to launch Starships for less than the original price of the Falcon 9 rocket, which was $6 million. However, a Starship would carry 400 times the payload of a Falcon 9, making this spacecraft the largest, most powerful, and most efficient in history. SpaceX estimates it must build several thousand vehicles annually and carry out 10 daily launches to send millions of tons of cargo to Mars. This seems utterly unfeasible today, but when it comes to SpaceX, it should not be taken lightly. Preparing for Mars. Musk aims to seed a civilization on Mars as humanity's first step towards becoming a multi-planetary species. To achieve this, he believes Mars will need a population of around 1 million people, with many millions of tons of supplies, so that colonists can mine, build, and grow things on Mars and thus become self-sufficient. This will require an absurd number of launches, roughly 10 per day, and sending hundreds of spaceships to Mars during the short launch gap that opens up between Earth and the Red Planet every 26 months. But how would these launches to Mars be carried out? As mentioned, Mars and Earth approach each other every 26 months. During this very short period, the distance between the two planets is only 54.6 million kilometers. This moment in which Earth and Mars are very close to each other is known as opposition. However, this is still a considerable distance compared to the distance from the Earth to the Moon, but modern technology can cover it in a few months. However, the opposition between Earth and Mars only lasts a few weeks. After that, Earth and Mars continue to advance in their respective orbits around the Sun and slowly move away, and 26 months later, they will be in opposition again. This means that sending a spacecraft to Mars without opposition will take a long time. If you want to take humans and materials to Mars, you must take advantage of the periods of opposition that last only a few weeks. One option to make the most of this is to send Starships full of materials and payload to low Earth orbit, and once there, send 5 or 6 more spacecraft to fill fuel at the first one. It will then stay in Earth's orbit while the same process is repeated with another spacecraft, such as Starship 2 and 3 and even a 4th and 5th. So when the opposition between Mars and Earth occurs again, there will be 4 to 5 Starships with materials and fuel entirely ready for takeoff and embarkation on the journey to the Red Planet. These spacecrafts would make the trip to Mars at the same time. Suppose each of the 5 spacecraft carries a payload of 200 tons. In that case, when the first astronauts arrive on Mars, they will have 1,000 tons of materials and supplies to help them settle comfortably and stay there for at least 26 months, since they will have to wait until the next opposition occurs for a return to Earth. Doubts on the viability of the project. Of course, more than a few experts have questioned the billionaire's Martian ambitions. As for Starship, it will have to prove that it is capable of participating in NASA's Artemis 3 mission to land on the Moon. Only then can the idea of sending humans to the Red Planet be taken seriously. How much you accept this view will depend on your preference for Musk and his dream of forging livable communities on an uninhabitable world like Mars. The engineering challenges are extraordinary, not to mention all the technology that would have to be developed to make life possible on a barren and cold planet. But people have been underestimating SpaceX for years, and this company almost always achieves what it sets out to do. When Musk first outlined his plans for Mars 8 years ago, experts dismissed his ideas as overly optimistic. But today, after SpaceX proved to the world that rocket reuse is a very viable thing to do, and with a vibrant Starship factory at hand, it seems that this company is very close to achieving its goals on the Red Planet. But at the end of the day, you have the last word. We want to know what you think. Do you consider SpaceX's goals to colonize Mars to be possible or completely unachievable? Let us know what you think in the comments.